All right. How you going? I'm an art teacher and practicing artist, and I've been trying to think of an idea to do a sculpture for the Forbes Sculpture Prize. So I didn't know whether to use metal or wood, but I was interested in mythology and myth and legend and this sort of thing. And I started to. It wasn't until I was at condo we learned about Hemingway at school. And so it wasn't until I had this big lump of wood that I decided to do Hemingway as a subject. He was quite an interesting guy because he was the new settlers couldn't catch him. And so they believed that he turned into a bird. I was living out at my parents' farm out at Boru where we got the wood, and I just started doing these small little carvings. This one's out of just clay, hasn't been fired or anything, but sort of gave me a bit of an idea about shape and form and sort of even the textures that I wanted to create. I'm more interested in sort of instead of smooth surfaces, I sort of wanted more flat planes to work with. I think it's a bit more interesting, and I didn't sort of really want to make it too perfect. Sort of wanted a bit more rough and ready, I guess. So I did a few sketches also. And the whole idea was the half bird, half man, Hemingway. So I took a little bit of time doing these, and I ended up getting a massive, big piece of wood, and it's taken a little while to sort of figure out how the wood works, because I'm usually a painter. I'm, in terms of sculpting, I do clay, but I haven't done much in terms of wood. So I had to go and get myself a new chainsaw, which was quite exciting. Went down to new planes. And that was quite good. I used chisels also and angle grinders. Find you get sanding bits and cutting bits. But yeah, it's quite a bit of drawing. I wish I put a few more different slides on, but that's all right. When I started with the piece of wood, it was it was pretty got the old man on the tractor, and we had to move it because it was outdoors, so we moved it into the shearing shed. And I asked the woodwork teacher at school what I needed to do to stop it from cracking and that sort of thing. So he gave me a bit of his special sort of sealer that I did the bottom with in the base. And hopefully that will stop it from cracking. My trusty dog here in the corner would always come in whenever I sort of went out to do a bit. And it was a good spot in the shearing shed because we set up lights and I could go in at night time, and I've been in and out of the dentist, so I've had days off where I could go and do a bit in the shooting shed. Dust was a bit of a problem. It's hard to get good goggles and sort of, you know, the respirators to be able to work comfortably. I found that quite difficult. Also the tools, like I was saying before, I think it took a while as well to figure out what tools would work. I finally found that the electric chainsaw was good because I could cut pieces and then knock them out just with a hammer, usually. I decided to start with the head and try and get the shape of the head and also the wings. I didn't really go with any sort of Michelangelo technique or anything, but I sort of just tried to go with my gut on it and tried to approach it the way I would approach even just a small maquette, sort of clay figure. I just tried to, you know, if I took too much off, you just have to work with the mistake, I guess. You can't sort of get too fussy about it. The material, it takes a long time to not work against it. You have to figure out how the material, you know, the extent of the material, how far you can push it, I guess. I'm thinking about actually leaving a few different types of textures. I kind of like the wing to be left in the bar. Other parts of it I think I like to get nice and smooth, but I want to keep it a similar sort of style to the way I had my maquettes in having sort of flat planes, as if they're being scooped out like clay. I worked on the hands, that took a little while. I had a good Sunday afternoon trying to fix the front up. I've still got to do the claws on the bottom face, but it's kind of coming along. The head's been quite difficult to do. Like I said, you've just got to work with the mistakes and turn your mistakes into the finished article, I guess. And then by the end of it, it should come together, hopefully. Don't have much time.